The Pop Warner Super Bowl Rap Show is presented by Genie. A dramatic day at the 60th Pop Warner Super Bowl. Santa Clara and Dorchester hook it up in a shootout at ESPN Wide World of Sports as Division II takes center stage. We welcome you to the Pop Warner Rap Show presented by Genie. I'm Tom James. Wow, what a day. So many highlights to get to, and we start with the games that you just saw from varsity semifinals, Dorchester and Santa Clara. First quarter, Lions already up 8-0, and Raymond Price III with the INT. Later in the first, Aaron Asing, maybe the best player in this entire Pop Warner tournament, taking the entire Eagles team to the end zone with him. It was 16-0. But don't sleep on Dorchester. They come back. Jonathan Barnes gets the handoff and finds his way to the end zone. In the second quarter, Santa Clara now leading 24-12. Ball up in the air, and Jonathan Barnes, the unintended wide receiver, catches it and scores the touchdown anyhow. 32-24 late in the second. Barnes again taking the direct snap, and he is gone for the touchdown, and that cut it to a 32-30 game. On to the second half. Same score, opening kickoff of the third quarter. Dorchester's Angel LeBron Jr. takes the return from right at his own goal line, cuts left, and takes it all the way down and to the 2-yard line. They would score two plays later. 38-32. They are in the lead. Santa Clara, though, Raymond Price Jr., a 25-yard touchdown run to retake the lead. And then who else? Aaron Asing with the long touchdown run. That would seal it for Santa Clara. They hang on and win a classic 48-44 to advance to the championship game. And the stats say it all. An absolute shootout, an offensive show between these two. Look at the numbers put up, mostly on the ground, some by the air. And the first downs, 18-17. The two turnovers for Dorchester may have cost them in the end. The other semifinal matchup, Palmetto against Northwest, scoreless. Second quarter, Carl Jones on the move. He's in there for the touchdown. And the team from Pennsylvania takes an 8-0 lead late in the second quarter. Palmetto's Darius Chester runs the ball. A helmet-to-helmet penalty gets called. And that would set up a first and goal. And Kelvin Durham crosses the plane for the touchdown. The lead would be 8-6 Northwest. Into the third quarter we go. And what a play by Edward Jefferson. He rocks the quarterback and then runs it all the way in for the touchdown for a 14-6 advantage. Still in the third quarter, Jasim Smith catches the touchdown pass to further extend the lead, and Northwest would defeat Palmetto. 30-6 is your final. So we are all set for the championship game on Saturday in Division I varsity. What a matchup it ought to be. East Coast versus West Coast as Northwest will tangle with Santa Clara. Now to the consolation games. The Harvey Colts against the Pompano Chiefs. Third quarter, Pompano on top, 8-6. Until a fumble occurs. Ball is on the ground, and Harvey would recover. Still in the third. That led to this, Stephen Reed, couple of stutter steps, back across and in for the touchdown. Harvey taking a 12-8 lead. Midway through the third quarter. And Pompano with the football. It is picked off by Trayvon Swanigan. He intercepts the pass. Across midfield he goes. And then the Colts give it to Stephen Reed. And he turns it on for a big gainer down inside the 10-yard line. Moments later, Reed would finish it off. dashing for the corner and getting in there inside the pylon for the touchdown. As we move to the fourth quarter, and Harvey continues to pile it on, and it's Steven Reed again, taking off. Great blocking from their offensive line, and Reed just refuses to be brought down in there for the touchdown. Your final score, the Harvey Colts go on to win it 34-8 over Pompano. And the final consolation game, two teams from way out west, Garden Grove against the Wahiloa Razorbacks. No score, first quarter. Daryl Sampaga catches the pass for the touchdown. The team from Hawaii on top early. The Bulldogs answer back. Dalen Pedroza wrestles his way into the end zone for the touchdown for an 8-6 advantage. Midway through the second quarter, Garden Grove's Malisi Griffith with the interception cuts across the field. One of many pick sixes this week here at the Pop Warner Super Bowl. It was 14-6 Bulldogs. And the Razorbacks, though, trying to fight back. Third quarter, Owen Palakiko runs it in for the touchdown to tie the game at 14 apiece. But later in the fourth, just under 5 minutes left to play, Chelsea Martinez into the end zone, crossing the goal line for the go-ahead win. And the team from Hawaii, Wailoa, is victorious over Garden Grove, 22-14. We've got more action coming up next. Highlights from the Pee-wees, the Junior Pee-wees, when we come back.
Go the distance with Disney and the ESPN Wide World of Sports Complex in Florida by training or competing in one of the many track and field events hosted here annually. From Disney Track and Field Spring Training to the Walt Disney World Cross Country Classic to Disney Track and Field Showcase, get ready for your season or get noticed by any of the numerous college recruiters in attendance. Check out DisneyTrackAndField.com for more information.
All kinds of fireworks today at the 60th Pop Warner Super Bowl, West Bay and Hartford. One of the many tight games on day four. As we welcome you back to the Pop Warner Rap Show presented by Genie. I'm Tom James. I've had the best seat in the house on a day packed with incredible action. Highlights from earlier today, Junior Pee-wee semifinals, Virginia Beach and Western New York. Sincere Hawkins, love the name, takes it in for the touchdown, and the Mustangs led it 6-0. In the second quarter, the Bills look to Lamar Colston, and he swings it in there for the score. That would tie the game at 6 apiece. Later in the second quarter, the Mustangs, Joseph Graham Jr. with the catch, the run, and the score, 14-6 Virginia Beach. In the third quarter, they look to Carvelis Scott, and he takes off on a long run down the sidelines and in for the score, 21-6 Virginia Beach. They were up 29-6 and then come up with the big INT with just under 9 minutes left in the game. They would add a touchdown moments later, went to the running clock, and the Mustangs defeat the Bills in a big way. 35-6 was the final. In the other semifinal, North Philadelphia against the far west Aztecs. Khalif Barrett trying the fake punt. He gets planted in the backfield. And then the Steelers would look to Connor Ging, who takes it in for the touchdown. Extra point was good. 8-0 far west. Into the fourth quarter, and how about the defense? Shahid Wilson gets dropped in the end zone. Tariq Trice Thornton causing the safety, and that would be the game. 10-0 far west pitches the shutout. So here is the championship game setting up for Saturday in the Junior Pee-wees. Noon Eastern time, far west takes on Virginia Beach in what should be a dandy. Now the consolation games from Junior Pee-wee, the West Bay Rams against the Hartford Hurricanes in the second quarter. The Hurricanes, Mason Cottrell on his back, but still makes the big catch. Later in the drive, Jaden Kopening finds the opening up the middle and in for the score. And that would make it a 12-0 game. On to the third quarter, ball on the ground. Check out Isaiah Alpati. He's got the cast on his right arm, picks it up with his left arm. Scoop and score. And that cut the lead to 12-7. But then Mason Cottrell again catches the pass in traffic, goes in for the score. That made it 18-7. It had been cut to 18-13 late in the fourth quarter. Final chance is no good for West Bay, and Hartford holds on for an 18-13 victory. And the final consolation game from Junior Pee-wees, from Miami, Overtown, the Tornadoes against Oak Cliff. Andrew Johnson catches the deep pass, actually the interception, and they are headed the other way, down inside the 30-yard line, bumped out of bounds near the 20. But that would not lead to any points. Scoring happened later in this game. Overtown in a defensive battle. Stay with us on the Genie Pop Warner Rap Show. All the action from junior varsity is next.
The ESPN Wide World of Sports Complex is the ideal place for amateur softball. Hosting annual events like Disney Softball Spring Training, on top of working with organizations like USSSA and Diamond 9 Events to develop competitive events for players of all ages and skill levels. For more information, visit ESPNWWOS.com.
There is Epcot, shot of Spaceship Earth from the monorail. ESPN Wide World of Sports from the Walt Disney World Resort. We welcome you back to the Pop Warner Rap Show presented by Genie. Big day in the junior varsity division. Football's bouncing everywhere and great plays being made. As we welcome you back inside our Genie Studios, I'm Tom James. So two semifinal games and two consolation games in JV. Let's take you right to the highlights. First, from the semifinals, North Philadelphia and Churchland. First quarter, rolling out. Yasim Johnson gets the interception. And he's going to run it back into Tiger territory. Then, North Philly, Khalif Barrett takes the ball down inside the five before being pushed out of bounds. He would score on the next play. Tied at seven all in the second quarter. There goes Barrett again, this time reaching the end zone, making it a 14-7 ball game. How about that spin by Cameron Jackson all the way to pay dirt? 20-7, it would be 26-7 late in the second quarter. Ball goes up in the air and it's intercepted, returned into Tigers territory. And then the Aztecs, Cameron Jackson, there's that tipped play coming up with the catch. And then Khalif Barrett, his third touchdown of the game. And your final score, 45-7 in a rout. North Philadelphia advances to the championship game. Will they play Richmond or Arizona? Third quarter action tied, well, no score. Breshard Smith carrying the football. His team pushes him, and they're still going across midfield. Boy, that is a team effort. Down to the 47-yard line, and Cornelius Collier would score moments later. He's into the end zone, hair and all, and it was 6-0, Richmond. Fourth quarter, still no score for Arizona. They're looking, last-ditch attempt falls incomplete. They could never get on the board as Richmond Pirine advances to the championship, 6-0 over Arizona. Let's take a look at that bracket. 9:30 in the morning, Saturday on ESPNU, the Junior Varsity Championship, Richmond against North Philadelphia. Should be a great one. Now the consolation games. First from Junior Varsity, it's Aurora and New Haven. Michael Ignafo Jr. with a little stutter step at the goal line, gets it across for the touchdown, and the Gators led it 6-0. In the second quarter, on second and four, Tyler Bishop with the reception, and he does the rest in there for the touchdown. Aurora would go ahead 20-6. Closing seconds of the second quarter. The little flea flicker back to the quarterback, and he's off to the races inside the 30, down inside the 20, across the 10, and into the end zone for the touchdown. New Haven back on the board, but to the fourth quarter we go. And tackled in the end zone for the safety by the Gators. It had to be the Sox as Aurora goes on to defeat New Haven 40-12. And the other consolation game from Junior Varsity, Oak Cliff against East Bay. First quarter, Jaylene Record runs down inside the 20 before being brought down. Later on in the drive, it would be Kevion Boston. Ball up in the air. Boston is there to make the catch for the score. And the Skins were on top 6-0. We move to the second half. Third quarter, Oak Cliff on top 12-0. They hand it to Jalen Record again. And he is off to the races. Scores another touchdown, 90 yards on the play. 18-6 late in the third quarter. Kevion Boston catches another touchdown pass to make it 24-6. And then Jaylene Record again, this time doing it on defense with the pick six and the touchdown. And your final score, the Redskins go on to win 30-12 was the final score. More highlights still to come on the Pop Warner Rap Show presented by Genie. Stay with us.
The ESPN Wide World of Sports Complex at the Walt Disney World Resort in Florida has emerged as the pinnacle of youth tournament travel, catering to the needs of the entire family. We offer a complete line of solution-oriented products and services to address the complex needs of teams on the road and the team parents who support them. To find out how to achieve vacation victory, visit ESPNWWOS.com.
A look at Disney's Animal Kingdom on day four of the Pop Warner Super Bowl ESPN Wide World of Sports as we welcome you back into the Pop Warner Rap Show presented by Genie. Semifinal action from the Pee Wee Division. Second quarter, Deer Valley and North Raleigh, and Donovan Fontaine breaks through for the touchdown. The Eagles go up first. Second quarter, North Raleigh answers back. Silas DeMary Jr. with the leaping catch. And then rolling out, North Raleigh's Noah Rogers on the reverse and takes it to the house for the touchdown to tie it at 8 apiece. Late in the second quarter, the little bubble scream, and DeMary Jr. gets outside, inside the 10, carrying would-be tacklers down inside the 5. And that sets up the touchdown run. Silas is in there for a 16-8 lead for the Bulldogs. On to the second half we go. On third and goal, Blake Raphael into the end zone, carrying the line. 24-8, North Raleigh now in front. In the fourth quarter, Deer Valley has closed to within 8. An incredible pass play. Donovan Fontaine to Alexander Barrer. They are in business. Less than 2 minutes left to play. North Raleigh's quarterback in all kinds of trouble, heaves it towards the end zone. It's tipped away at the last second on what would have been a touchdown that could have led to a tie game. And North Raleigh survives over Deer Valley 24-16. The Patriots versus Sweetwater on the red field, the other semifinal. The Hawks, Micah Simmons on the opening kickoff, an onside kick attempt. He wasn't fooled as he takes it to the house for the touchdown. Sweetwater on top, 7-0. Later in the first quarter, a fumble, and Marcus Peterson Jr. recovers it, and that led to this. Micah Simmons again, weaving through the defenders and in for the touchdown to make it 14-0. Late in the second quarter, the Hawks, Maurice Evans Jr. in there for the score. It was 26-6, Sweetwater. Late second quarter, Dominic Muscanero goes up, catches, and then runs it down inside the 5-yard line. That would lead to a touchdown. Third quarter now, 26-14, and the Patriots' Caleb Miller takes it in for the touchdown as they draw ever closer to within 4. But the Hawks' Charles Thompson making a nice catch. And then in the fourth quarter, they respond to the Patriots' surge. Micah Simmons into the corner for the score, and Sweetwater holds on, distances themselves from the Patriots, and win it 39-22. So the matchup is set for the championship in the Pee Wee Division on Saturday, 2:30. Sweetwater takes on North Raleigh. Your consolation games, the Gilroy Browns against North Philadelphia. And another set of fireworks on the opening kickoff. Isaac Alvarez Saldivar picks it up, finds some blockers, sees daylight, and takes off down the sidelines. A long 87-yard kickoff return for the touchdown and an early 6-0 lead. Still in the first quarter, just moments later, Dylan Pindle, as the Aztecs come back, catches it and goes to the house. And the team from Pennsylvania takes a 7-6 lead. On to the second quarter, North Philly on top 14-6. They go deep. The reception by Rashawn Wright down inside the 5-yard line. That would lead to a score. North Philly up by 14, and then a fumble, and Dylan Pindle picks it up, the scoop, and the score. And North Philly goes up by 20. Still in the second quarter, the Aztecs call on Mikael Oliver. He is across the 40, down inside the 30. He's got his eyes on the end zone and is in there for the score. And the Aztecs roll over the Gilroy Browns and get a victory to go home with 42-6 in the final consolation game in the Pee Wee division. It's Dorchester and Loveland. Loveland's Isaiah Strange catches the pass, and he's off to the races. Nobody will catch him. The Titans took an 8-0 lead. On to the third quarter. Loveland on top, 14-6. Dorian McCarty, the long run after the reception, inside the 20, cuts it towards the middle and finds his way to pay dirt. 22-6, Loveland would be in front. End of the third quarter, ball in the air, and Tegan Hevalone intercepts it and runs it in. So many pick sixes in this Super Bowl. It's just incredible. The defense stepping up in so many ways. And the Loveland Titans get the victory over Dorchester, 38-6. A flurry of Genie top plays on this crazy day. We'll have them for you straight ahead. Stay with us.
ESPN Wide World of Sports Complex at Florida's beautiful Walt Disney World Resort is your amateur basketball destination. Offering multiple tournaments for athletes from peewee to collegiate level, the complex also attracts NCAA coaches from top programs nationwide. To find out how your team can compete here, visit DisneyBasketball.com.
Not all about football at the Pop Warner Super Bowl. Tomorrow, live at 5 Eastern time, it's the National Cheer and Dance Championships. Watch it here on ESPN3, streaming live on the Watch ESPN app. Well, welcome back to the Pop Warner Rap Show, presented by Genie. I'm Tom James. We have seen it all today. And it's time for the Genie top plays. Let's count them down. Starting at number five, the junior Pee-wee's Virginia Beach, Joseph Graham Jr. catches the pass 39 yards, dragging the defender into the end zone for the score. Number four, from Pee-wee's, Gilroy against North Philly. And the opening kickoff of the game, Isaac Alvarez Saldivar, looking for daylight, finds it. Thanks to his blockers, he's got plenty of room to run, and he is off to the races 87 yards for the touchdown. Top play number three from the junior Pee-wee's, Hartford's, Mason Cottrell slips, falls, but catches the ball. An incredible play by Cottrell. Number two, junior varsity, North Philly, Cameron Jackson lays out and catches the ball off the tip just before it hits the carpet. What a snatch. And finally, your Genie top play of the day, Deer Valley Eagles, Donovan Fontaine scrambling, going right, eluding would-be tacklers, headed back to his left, launches one in the air, but Raleigh's defensive back Lex Thomas gets in the way of what would have been a giant play at the last second. A huge defensive play that helped North Raleigh reach the championship game. And what an incredible day it has been. Let's take a look at the full schedule of action. Still to come on Friday, the Division II Championship Day. Junior Pee-wees gets us started at 8:30 in the morning. Southeast Dallas versus Point Loma. That'll be followed by the junior varsity title game, Fort Osage and Northwest. Then at 1:15, the Pee-wees take center stage. Hoffman Estates, it's the Hawks against the Riviera Beach Chargers. And finally at 3:15 in the Unlimiteds, St. Pete battles Gilbert Chandler for the championship. That's Friday, live right here on ESPN3. And of course, we always take time out here at ESPN to remember our old friend, head coach Jim Valvano. It is Jimmy V week for cancer research. And of course, one in two men, one in three women will develop cancer in their lifetimes. It's the second most common cause of death in the U.S. If you would like to give, log on to jimmyv.org, or you can call 1-800-JIMMY-V to donate. It was founded back in 1993 by Jim Valvano and ESPN. Incredible, incredible cause. That's going to do it for the Pop Warner Rap Show presented by Genie. I'm Tom James. We'll see you Friday. Have a great night, everybody.